Duty calls. Kate gets her hands dirty as she swaps her stylish blazer for a £350 anorak to go litter picking with William in Wales, as baby Archie makes his debut in Windsor. The Duchess of Cambridge proved she's not afraid to get her hands dirty today as she donned an anorak and sturdy boots to go litter picking with William on a beach in North Wales. Kate, who yesterday revealed she can't wait to meet her new nephew, also managed to get a baby fix while visiting the Carnarvon Coast Guard search and rescue helicopter base. Greeting the adorable youngster, a child of one of the search and rescue team, Kate grinned widely and proceeded to pat the cute baby on the head before gently stroking the little girl's legs. While Prince Harry and Meghan were introducing the world to their adorable new son Archie at St. George's Hall in Windsor, Kate and William returned to familiar territory today, meeting former colleagues. Earlier in the day, Kate, looking striking in a £762 red woolen blazer by Lorenzo Serafini and skinny black jeans, joined the 36-year-old father of three, who looked delighted to be touring the helicopter base, even if the weather didn't quite play ball. Yesterday, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge told the world they were thrilled with a new arrival in the royal family, with William cheekily joking that he was looking forward to welcoming his brother to the sleep deprivation club. Kate, 37, who told reporters in London yesterday that she's desperate to meet her brand new nephew, teamed her smart red blazer, a favorite that she's worn before, with a pair of skinny black jeans and knee-length black suede boots. The Duchess, wearing her brunette locks pulled back in a flowing ponytail, which accentuated her simple amber drop earrings. She finished the look with a smart crocodile skin black handbag from upmarket leather goods store Aspinall of London, which sells for a cool £495. Meanwhile, Prince William donned a dark blue suit, with a racing green sweater and smart suede brogues for the trip to his former home. The royal, who worked for 3 years at RAF Valley on Anglesey from 2010 to 2013, made the trip north, on a soggy day, to reacquaint himself with the invaluable work being done by the search and rescue helicopter team and Wales Air Ambulance in the region. The unit William worked on has now moved from the island to the new base, Carnarvon, on the mainland and is run by Bristow Helicopters, which took over the contract from the military, but still has some of the same crew from William's time as a helicopter pilot. William told his old crew that he does miss his old job, which involved flying rescue missions in all kinds of weather and terrain. Coast Guard helicopter wingman Paul Jones and his wife Gemma were with their sons, Finley, 12, and Alex, aged 9, who were much younger the last time Kate and William saw them. Mr. Jones said, "It's lovely to see him. We worked very closely for 3 years and then he moved away. It was like he's never been away." The royal couple also clambered aboard the Coast Guard's new £30 million Sikorsky S-92 helicopter, which replaced Sea King helicopters used during William's time with the unit. Both royal visitors sat in the cockpit as they were told about the aircraft's capabilities and performance during the around 300 or so rescue missions undertaken each year from Carnarvon. Rich Taylor, a wingman who served with William and met him again today, said, "It was great. It was a real honor and privilege. He's a very nice guy, very engaging, very professional. He worked very hard, obviously, to keep a balance in the worlds he's within. He was outstanding in his role as a pilot." William and Kate also joined a discussion with Coast Guard crew members and staff from Wales Air Ambulance about the mental health challenges that result from working as emergency personnel. Mr. Taylor added, "He's been involved firsthand with some awful situations as anyone who works in this search and rescue or air ambulance will have been, so he knows firsthand the effects it can have on people. When we worked with William, it was a real honor and a privilege, and that continues, that he's taken the time out to come and see us and have a look around and catch up again. I think, like anybody involved in aviation, especially emergency services and support and helping others, it's a passion, it's a vocation. So I can understand he does miss it." William and Kate spent around 90 minutes at the base before shaking hands and saying goodbyes as they traveled to their next stop on the royal visit at Hale and Moan Anglesey Seasalt, a local business on Anglesey. The couple headed to their former home, where they lived as newlyweds in a Welsh farmhouse until William left the RAF. At the salt-making company, Kate and William had a go at making the condiment in the traditional way, getting a masterclass in the process. Their brief tour continued with a stroll on Newborough Beach, where the couple explored the beach's wildlife habitat. The coastal spot meant a change of outfit for Kate, with the Royal swapping out her red blazer for a more practical £350 Troy London Navy parka with a barber body warmer underneath. She also pulled on a favorite pair of flat-heeled leather knee-high boots by Penelope Chilvers. William was seen wearing a pair of blue Nike trainers after leaving the smarter brogues he'd had on earlier behind and ditching his jacket in favor of a warmer-looking coat. Earlier in the day, the Duchess of Cambridge looked on sparkling form as she strode forward to greet members of the Coast Guard search and rescue helicopter team, or perhaps she was just trying to escape the Welsh drizzle. Back in Windsor, just as the couple began chatting to the search and rescue members, Prince Harry and Meghan introduced their son, who still has no official name, to the world's media. Yesterday, as the couple launched the inaugural King's Cup regatta at the Cuddy's Ark, in southeast London, proud Uncle William told well-wishers he is looking forward to meeting his nephew in the next few days once things have quietened down. He added jokingly, "I'm very pleased and glad to welcome my own brother into the sleep deprivation society that is parenting." Kate, who looked chic in a nautical-inspired outfit for the outing, shared her husband's delight, saying, "It's such a special time, obviously with Louis and Charlotte just having had their birthdays. It's such a great time of year to have a baby. Spring is in the air." The couple also revealed they do not yet know the baby's name. Baby Sussex arrived at 5:26 a.m. on Monday, weighing 7 pounds 3 ounces. It is expected he will be seen for the first time tomorrow after Harry and Meghan decided to eschew the tradition of a photo call in the hours after the birth. However, Prince Harry did make a short media appearance to share his excitement and reveal that Meghan and the baby were doing well.